My name is Sherry Bretz. I live in the United States of America. I have been a victim of some dark group for over 10 years that has used advanced unseen weapons to hack my brain, produce thoughts in my head without my awareness until they later tell me on certain days what they've done, because I will say the same things a year later that I said on a particular day on the internet, and they will bring it up to me to prove to me that they're really in my mind controlling it. And all those years I had enough pride being a Leo to insist that it couldn't be done, that you couldn't read someone's thoughts, that you couldn't whittle away walls of their brain and get through to their subconscious mind and be able to produce thoughts. I've since come to see that there's a diabolical force on the planet that is so evil that it is using man and science and weapons to get through our mortal minds and take full possession of our bodies and destroy our defenses. The only thing that keeps me going is my faith in God and my strong willpower. I realize today that the oppressor who thinks I'm his possession has actually turned me into a stooge. And he said that he would. He said, he bragged and said, I'm giving you a lobotomy from space because I would not break completely. I would not make him think that he had full power over me. Even when he stole all my stories and he hacked my brain and he made my mother sick and he tormented her. And even after she died and he still continued to try to beat me down in the dirt and destroy me for my Christian values, I still kept the faith. Every day I fought to be strong for God, every day. I felt the world depended on some people to see through the facade, to let people know the real evil that is disguised so cleverly today through film and books and media companies and these space weapons that control the cyber network that is named after the devil, Pan, and it's used for mind control, and Apollo was named after Satan too. And a long time ago, when some of our leaders decided to send a rocket into space, I believe it was to invade the heavens, because that's described in the Bible as something the devil does. And ever since then, we have been victims of mind control. But before that, I think they were experimenting during the Holocaust when Hitler was here. They were taking people's privacy, destroying their rights, but degrading them in the worst way imaginable for Satan, and even saving their shoes and their personal possessions. Do you know when they put me in Disney films, Disney animation, and when they stole all my life and kept me enslaved here and ganged me through their skull and deer hunters, I call them. They're human hunters. You know, a lot of them use the deer antler symbol. That's been in the old movie props in the horror movies for ages. When they harass me and follow me and tell me they're wearing me down to destroy my soul so the Antichrist can take me over, and they try to talk to me with subliminally with their, I guess, psychics through CIA or some dark branch of government. Some dark branch of government is trying to communicate with me through these weapons, whittling away at my mind so they can try to either make clairvoyant psychics for government, or they're what they call aliens, infiltrate my brain every single night that cause irreparable damage. Then I realize man has reached its limits. The devil's taken over. And if what they call are aliens or demons, then man brought this dark fate on himself through our promiscuous lifestyle, through our selfish desires, and through the day that Eve ate forbidden fruit. You can never blame God for any of this. God is not responsible for the evil that man does. Man has a very twisted mind. Your mind is a weapon. You can use it to heal. Like that song, you know, that song, Everybody Get Together, Love One Another Right Now. That song is has a powerful message. The song tells you everything you need to know. It talks about we can make the angels cry or we can make them happy. It's up to us. We can kill or we can heal. And we've reached a dark age to where people think they're too powerful for God. They let their ego take over and they want to kill. But my story is so long, I really can't go into details today. I can only say that this person thought they had me completely possessed. They thought that there was no turning point. They said that I was getting weaker all the time. They said it wasn't just my brain they were destroying. My soul, they said, had finally gotten too weak. A friend of mine sent me an invite to go to France to work with him on his life story. His name was Simon Marston. And I was invited to because I had been writing and telling him I was trapped. These people had all these evil symbols and things that I knew nothing about, and I thought they were into witchcraft and stuff. And I knew he took a lot of gothic pictures and things, but he told me he was a Christian. He was not at all into evil, but he wanted to talk to me. So I got to talk to him about what was happening in my life, to ask him his help, his knowledge. And at that time, they were killing me. I had been to the ER. They had messed my heart up. I was burning every night. They were not letting me sleep over 3 hours. I was dying of sleep deprivation. I went to a psychiatrist one time and he couldn't even get my eyes to go to the side. They would go like this far, but my brain was so broken and weak that I couldn't go past that. On either way, I couldn't go any further. So when I went to Europe, it was to try to save my life. I knew that there was no other outlet. They would kill me. And after I met this person, he said, "I will help you." And then he said he'd be my knight of the haunted room. And he asked me if I would promote him and be his American agent. So I became his American agent and built him a website and started promoting his last book. At that time, some people contacted me who claimed that they had written a story and that it matched his Twilight book. But actually, his Twilight story came out over a year before their book did. And coincidentally, this person happened to later go to the same publishing company that published his book. But he said, "I will be your knight of the haunted realm, and we're going to work on a book together called The Dark Room." And I thought, well, thank God, somebody's taking me under his wing. But you know, the attacks did not stop. They did not stop even though he was working with me and trying to help me. If anything, they started trying to just, they interfered. They destroyed all my writing that I sent to him on the internet. So I had to start going to the post office to snail mail him things. And then he ended up dying shortly after that, a little bit over a year after that. He died. We were both working on the story together, but he died before our story could be published. Well, here I am today. And this person who thinks I'm his full possession says if I push him out of my mind, I will be dead. Well, yesterday I started celebrating Vladimir Putin's birthday and I started posting pictures of Vladimir Putin. That person started sending me songs saying that I would be sorry if I walked away. And they started acting as if I had some relationship with this person, you know, telling me, "Well, you'll have to die because you betrayed me," and all this. I've never talked to this person face to face that I know of. Maybe I have at a writer's conference. This person really is serious. Last night, they put a song on about losing your breath, and at that minute, they had those weapons, and they started attacking my heart. I couldn't breathe. They really will kill me at the mere thought of me not being in this energy weapon prison. But I just want to say that when I thought I was really dying in the past and I was burning all over and my body couldn't take it, I thought about Vladimir Putin and a video I'd seen where he went and got baptized to the church. And the day that he was baptized, it was on a saint's day. And all of a sudden, this higher power that I thought must have been the power of God, it just felt like it took me over and gave me the strength and the faith to combat whatever energy weapon this person was using on me. And strange enough, when I felt that I was going to die, I bought a ticket to Russia to go check out the country to see if there was any hope there. At that time, that person attacked me in a way that I've never repaired, broke my mind. And they said it's because I let someone in my brain and it pushed them out and they could not come back in. But they keep telling me every week, "Let me back in your mind. You're going to be sorry." And after that, they blinded me. I mean, my vision, I've been to the doctor 5 times in 1 year and my vision shot. I can hardly see signs now. Everything's blurry. And they keep telling me it's going to get worse. They said, let us back in your brain. Let us back in your heart. They never were in my heart, not once. But they tricked themselves into thinking that they've never been in my heart. Let us back into your mind. And then yesterday, this person says, well, maybe it's just hopeless cause. Anyone who's in this program always dies. And he said, I made a mistake of falling in love with you, but I guess I'll just kill you because it seems hopeless that you're never going to let me back into your mind. Well, I had posted those birthday greetings about Vladimir Putin last night. So then they attacked my heart. Well, they attacked my brain so bad today. I got up, the phone rang, and this man who sounded Mexican wanted to know if I would do a survey about groceries and which is my favorite grocery and why. And I had told him my two favorite stores. And then I told him why. Well, then you're supposed to rate things as they go over the cleanliness, the freshness of the food, the availability compared to other products, blah, blah, blah. And at first, the first 5 minutes was fine. You know, I would give them numbers. And when it got into the second part, my brain couldn't do it. Something so basic. It just made me want to cry. I feel like such a stooge now. You know, like I'm just going to be a burden to people because he won't stop destroying my brain because I will not let him have full control of my body with these weapons. He wants like a remote control human. But more than that, he wants to take my brain. He wants to use it and he wants to infiltrate me and wipe out every part of me there is and just more or less inhabit my body through his dark force, his evil, his psychic power, his equipment, whatever. He really thinks that aliens or satanic beings can have full control of me and completely dissolve Sherry. So each day he says he's destroying my emotions. He's destroying my identity. He said my sweetness is gone. He says I no longer laugh. I used to laugh. He said, and I thought, no, did I? I looked at pictures just even when I was in France with Simon. At that time I felt broken, but I was laughing and smiling, and he said, but your soul would smile. He goes, now your soul is shot. You'll have to go in the woods to find your soul. He goes, you don't laugh anymore. And he said he wanted to make me cry every day and feel despair and like there was no hope left in life. Well, once you realize you cannot be happy again because he monitors me 24 hours a day. And any good mood he destroys in 5 minutes. He'll either attack my body or he'll have somebody follow me or he'll create some sort of terror. This has gone on for over 15 years. Only through the power of God I'm here. I'm only through my strength and faith. But I find it totally amazing that of all the battles I fought with this person, when I got the weakest and just started thinking that the world was doomed, there was no hope, then Vladimir Putin appeared right before the Olympics. And I started thinking, boy, he's a really unique person. You know, just something about his looks. And I thought, he got me curious. Just the first few times I saw him, I thought, he's really, for some reason, he intrigues me. He captures my interest. He captivates me. What is it about this person that's so extraordinary that's not like other people? And then I started feeling a connection to him, an energy, like we both were on a mission for Christ. And I started feeling like closer to God through him. When I would look at him, all of a sudden, all this darkness and evil that had a hold on me felt like it was in the background. It wasn't consuming me. I wasn't no longer brainwashed. I was no longer, and I thought, well, you know, they talk about saints being able to work miracles. And I thought, well, maybe if he's a saint, wouldn't he have the power to be able to work miracles to make me be freed of demons? I mean, if this person is using demons, wouldn't it make him like someone that should be like with a church canonized as a saint? Because what is this powerful gift that this man has to expel my demons, something. So it wasn't just his looks and his strength that gave me confidence. There's something far greater than that in this person that I don't quite understand what is. It's just, and so there was one night I thought I was dying and he was crushing my heart with these weapons. And I just, so there was a picture on the internet of Vladimir and I looked at it. And I just prayed, and all of a sudden, it was like this strong force or white light just surrounded me. And that evil and these power of these weapons just dissolved. It was like an invisible shield, and it couldn't get through it. So now I see today on his birthday that somebody's trying to push him out of office. They don't want him to be reelected. Well, I expected that during the Ukraine. I mean, the Ukraine thing to me just seemed like a Trojan horse to get close to Russia. You know, Russia's a big country. I don't think people can just go in and easily tear it down. I mean, If you want to infiltrate something, I guess you would get around the borders and then you would get your spies in there and your listening devices, and you would get to know everything about the country's security. You know, you might even put a Disneyland there so that you can get your people who are your spies disguised as actors to go in there and get information. And, you know, it's amazing how weak people can be when it comes to lust and money and fame. How some people that you really trust, you think that are your best friends, will turn on you so easily. So today, I woke up feeling really discouraged that I had trouble going through a stupid survey. By the time I got to the end of it, I no longer could keep my numbers straight. I no longer could rate certain things. That it's just common sense that a kindergartner could do it. My brain, I told the guy, I said, I can't stretch my mind any further. It's reached its limit. I said, now that I'm giving you numbers, I don't even know whether to give you high or low. What number represents what? I can't. And if someone now challenges me or attacks me, not used to be rearing to deal with the challenge or fight for my beliefs, they whittle away your self-defense. They whittle away your respect, your resistance. They have destroyed it. If someone wants to confront me now and try to get through, I just put my hands over my face because there's nothing left to fight with. There's not enough. My brain wants to just break off. And it's hard now, the past week or two, to stay focused when before I had great focus, great attention span. And when they tore my brain up so much, they sent me something on like attention deficit the past couple weeks. They brag about destroying my mind. Whatever this program is, as long as they keep you in afraid, as long as they keep you fighting to live every day and trying to reach another level, you exist. But the minute you say this is evil, this is foolish, I'm getting out of this, they kill you. Then they do permanent things. They've given me a permanent ailment now that will never go away, that I'll be sick every day. And they tore my rotary cuff tear a couple weeks ago to where if I try to lift it, it's too much pain and I can't go straight up. They told me that. They said they're attacking my kidneys now to try to wipe my heart out. They've been attacking my heart. They're doing all this because I got too strong to be their slave, to be frightened for 15 years. What person could have stood this one day? Only through the power of a God did I withstand it for 15 years. Before all their attacks, I could go to the doctor, and after a couple weeks, I could get better. Now they want blood, they want death, they want me permanently damaged for life, like with this blindness, with my back being torn. They don't want me to ever repair. This has happened since the last election. They seem to think I had something to do with it, which is crazy. I'm not in politics. I'm just a Southern woman here that didn't finish college. I had college, some classes, but I didn't finish because these people came along and kept stealing all my work, for my internet work for the college. I was going to UCLA, and then I went to New York Film Academy, and I went to JCC, but these people came along and just stole everything, and they said they would always steal my life and break in if they had to, and they did. They said, once you're chosen, you can never escape. But today is Vladimir Putin's birthday, and that gives me something to rejoice in, and I'm so happy that he is doing great, and he looks fabulous. He looks younger all the time. I think it's sad to see that he's already going to have another battle to face if he decides to run again for president. I think he's the only one that can save Russia. I think Dmitry Medvedev is a great leader. I think he's a powerful, strong man. He won't take no crap off nobody. Nobody. He means business. And he's very well educated. And Vladimir Putin has also been his mentor. I think they're an unbeatable team. It'd be great to see Vladimir retire now and enjoy his children, enjoy the fruits of his labor. But, you know, a saint, he may never get to retire, you know, because he's saving the world. He's not doing this for Vladimir mainly. He's doing this because he has a higher calling and he has a lot of virtue. You know, it'd be great to see Dmitry president again. And then that way he and Vladimir can work together, and then there can be a new vice president if Vladimir decides to retire. But I think that Vladimir has been the most powerful leader. He has not used any nukes. He has not attacked America aggressively, which I think other men would have. I think other men would have definitely accepted the challenge and definitely tried to strike back when Russia was under attack. But I think Vladimir was smart enough to know that there would be no winners if you start setting off these nukes and you let your ego take over or your desire for control. The whole planet would lose. And I think Vladimir had to suck in his pride, and he had to bow down a lot of times in order to keep peace around the world. He had to humble himself because he knew what was at stake. He was wise and compassionate and loving and mature enough to spend his time reinforcing his country and building up walls to try to protect his citizens. And I don't think any president could ever have his patience or his intelligence, his sixth sense, his godliness, or his background. Here's my phone. I'm going to have to finish. I think Russia's in great hands with him, but who knows what the future holds if he does decide to retire.